This time I'd like to call to order the landfill standing committee for the advanced disposal of Menlo Park landfill at 4:10 PM for August 3rd, 2015. Would the secretary please read the roll?
Greg Burmeister?
Here.
Rebecca Masano?
Here.
Colleen Madden?
Here.
Donald T. Gates, absent.
Right, excuse.
Roland Kiefer?
Here.
Patrick Murray?
Here.
Mark Spoken?
Here.
Arvid Schweitzer?
Here.
Myself, David Simpson. Mike Hackney?
How about Michael Conley? Did you call my name?
I do so.
I did hear.
Michael Conley, I could hear you.
Okay, here.
So you get for me late last night.
Missed last night.
Yes.
You're off the lead, you're correct. We cut you.
Traded you.
Yep.
Did you get public notice?
Meeting was noticed, according to the meeting records laws on July 27th.
No.
Approval of the minutes of the June 1st, 2015 meeting, how do you wish to move?
To approve.
I would like to make a correction.
Can I get a second, please?
Second.
Thank you. Okay.
Okay, I see my name didn't appear on the list there.
There was an error of the roll call, I just noticed that myself. So I was seeing, who I was seeing on the roll call, I believe we're missing Rebecca, Eileen, Craig.
Yeah.
Is anyone else missing on that roll call? Are those three people? I'm not sure we added.
Eileen, Greg, and who else?
Me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, any other corrections, additions? Upon hearing none, all those in favor of the minutes as corrected, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? The minutes are accepted unanimously. Okay, open forum. No one here?
I guess I have a question on the minutes.
Go ahead.
I know there wasn't a lot of discussion on any of the topics last time.
Right.
But when there is, there's gonna be a little more detail of what's happening here.
That's the plan, yes.
Okay.
Well, could I question a little bit?
Go ahead.
So I should probably send everyone a link here to the minutes. Basically, the way it's set up is it's kind of like we do in the city. If you go into the interactive agenda on the website, it'll take you directly to a video, and then that video will click on an item, it'll link directly to that spot. So, if you want to take a look at how we do them and see what you think.
Well, I printed them and had nothing. I did. I went there and printed them off the site, and there's no detail there.
Right. So they won't be in writing. What I'm saying is, you basically go to the website and click on a particular item that you're interested in. It'll take you directly to that spot in the video, and you'll be able to listen verbatim what happened in the meeting.
Or on video.
Right.
Oh,
so that video.
So you have to do the video to get the minutes. Take your own minutes.
You would click on that link and be able to hear exactly what's discussed.
No paper trail.
Not of discussion topics. But we can certainly add whatever you like. Not a problem.
Come watch yourself. Except you don't do
that. I'd rather have paper. I'd rather read it.
You're not a computer guy.
I'd rather read
Neither
it also.
Neither is Don. Yeah, and I think there's... Not everybody is.
I guess my concern is, recently there hasn't been a lot of topics that would make a whole lot of difference, I don't think. But in years past, there's been a lot of discussion and a lot of things came up that I think everybody wants the same verbiage. Not my interpretation of what someone said, and by the time it gets, I write it and share it with someone and then they write it and share it, it's, I don't know. I think at some point there should be, some of these should be on paper.
Yeah, but it's posted as the video. I mean, exactly what happened. So there's no interpretation because it's not even shorthand or anything. It's right there, exactly what happened.
And that's fine for those that have computers and are computer literate.
Sure.
But for those that aren't, that doesn't address the issue.
Time for us to
well,
be
I didn't
clear.
Know that was the issue.
Yeah, it is is really the issue is.
Okay.
That all citizens could have access to it.
Right, right.
But weren't the written minutes posted online? And I'm not trying to be anything but.
But he's saying he doesn't do written minutes anymore.
Right, but if they were not computer savvy, the minutes were only available online anyways.
You could go to City Hall.
Saying was, we've got a great deal of transparency with video, but if Harvey answers someone's questions, he watches the video. He takes his interpretation and says it. That next person has the opportunity to play telephone with that. If he had them online printed, he could easily print them up, read them off, or share them correctly. I think that's where he meant that the, you know, the determination is made by the viewer, and then it gets shared with the next person.
Here's an example. Rolly doesn't have a computer at home. Okay? His access is through him, his employer at work. And the employer is kind enough to let the material we have now come into work. Is he going to allow Rolly to sit there and scroll through video minutes at work? I don't think so. At least I wouldn't.
And I know Don doesn't use a computer either.
No. So what I think you're hearing is we want verbiage in the minutes talking about discussion so that when somebody wants to go back, especially a year back, year and a half, 2 years back, you've got something there as to why the committee arrived at the decision that it arrived at.
Isn't there a way to record that and it comes on in writing?
Mike?
This is,
speak up.
Okay, I'm sorry. A long time ago on the police department when I was there, they would dictate reports, the officers, detectives would dictate reports, and then they'd be turned into a paper. They had to be a paper report at that time.
Right.
Is it possible to do something like that? In other words, somehow they're transcribed into written matter?
Well, that would be word for word. You don't want that much detail.
No.
You want more of a summary, right?
Yes. But it would be...
A word for word would be better than this.
Okay, yes. But say, for example, Harvey talks about a given issue for 3 or 4 minutes. The minutes would have a summary of what he talked about and the direction he was going. So, you know, you might have 30 seconds worth of reading to cover his 5 minutes. Is that what I'm getting? Is that what you're getting at?
Yeah, I think so. You know, it's, I guess some of the things recently have been MSD project. You know, there was a lot of, we're gonna close this, move that, do whatever. I guess if that would have come to fruition where we were closing several plants, I think we would want that on paper versus my looking at it on a video.
Yeah.
And interpreting why Muskego closed versus the Franklin site. Because I've just experienced enough of those things to know that they get ugly fast.
Mm-hmm.
And once too many people have misinterpreted, it's like impossible to stop.
So what if we, as a compromise, say, if there's a specific subject that we know we might have to relate back to, instead of, like you said, there's not anything really exciting going on at the moment, but if something were to come up that we would just say, you know, please do detailed minutes on this particular subject.
Now, is that something you could do, like we could come to the meeting this month and say, I really need more information on clay extraction. And so for the next meeting, we could have the minutes revised for that. Like Eileen is saying, you know, maybe we thought there was more information needed on clay extraction and it could be gotten.
It can be. can't really revise the minutes, but you could have an addendum to them.
I think that's really what he was asking for. More detail on that particular topic of interest.
At a later date, because you're right, every topic, we don't want a great deal of information or don't need it. But there may be one or two that we feel that, hey, I want more information on that. So that could be done. That's might be an easy solution.
Was that, you just saying what Harry was saying?
Yeah, so I'll add a little more to the next time. I'm just gonna see what everyone thinks.
Okay.
Do you do any of that over at City Hall for meetings?
No, we just do the video only, and then we record motions, so like the final result. Mm-hmm. But we certainly could do it that way, it's not a problem.
Let me back up a little bit and give a little history on City Hall and minutes. Starting way back when we went from a township to a city, that was a, if you go back and look at some of the very original minutes, you will see that some of that discussion came up. You'll also see some input from the attorney saying that all you need legally to have in the minutes is the motion and the result. You don't need any of the discussion. And from a legal standpoint, having all that discussion in there will get you in trouble later on. And I asked that question back in, I don't know, 98, 99 of our then city attorney about that particular issue. Because I had gone back to try to research some things that the city had done years ago. And the decision was made that the minutes will contain the motions and the vote, and that's basically it. They'll have the subject matter, but that's basically it. And they went from the attorney's recommendation. When I asked about that back in 98 to the attorney at a meeting, at a council meeting, you could tell he did not want to respond, but basically what he did say is that the information that's there will potentially incriminate you in the future in a lawsuit. Well, if there's something we have done that is wrong and we don't recognize it, we stand accountable for it. And if you get sued, and your own minutes, you know, show that you should have done something different, well, then so be it. I mean, we're human, we make mistakes.
I think the reason we do it today is because when you have written minutes, you have one person's interpretation of what happened. And when you have everything in video, you have the live, actual, this is exactly what took place. So you don't have an interpretation there, you have facts. So I think that's why we do it that way today. I understand that not everybody has a computer, and that it's easier to have those minutes, in some cases, spelled out, you know, instead of having to look them up online. Though.
Yeah.
So, it, you know, we'll try to accommodate those, and we'll always still have the video to fall back on if we need more facts.
What did it take?
Now, in the history of the city, how many times have the city lost its historical data because of survey issues, backup issues?
Never, I don't.
Oh, most certainly did. We have some very summary data that goes back, but we lost 2,000 or so, and it was a failure of backup. What was supposed to have been happening automatically wasn't.
Well, there's a different IT industry department.
cameras are set at two different places now. So if it got lost at City Hall, it's at an off-site as well. It's not just at City Hall.
It's backed up automatically.
It's backed up, yeah. It's backed up in more than one place now.
Okay. But I have yet to see foolproof backup. Okay. So, you've got an understanding of what you think the committee's looking for?
Topics that seem a little more important, we'll put some detail. If it seems like a more day-to-day operation, we'll leave it as a committee member.
Okay.
That work, kind of same?
Yep. And probably this topic was a little more important. Right?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, should I do yours now?
Well, we're gonna do a tour, and I'm gonna do the audit on the tour, so.
Okay.
That would cover everything, because.
What tour?
Past and present.
Hmm? We're doing a tour?
Okay.
But doesn't mean I need to see, by the way.
That's what I said.
It's in the minutes.
Gotcha.
Huh?
It's in the minutes.
Just where? Pick that up.
Okay, if there's no objections, we are going to do.
Was it in the minutes?
Adjourn to the tour.
Rolling?
What's that?
No objections, we're going to go on a landfill tour now?
Yeah, I guess so, but I didn't even know we were going on a tour, otherwise I might have come a little later, but.
You don't have to go, I'm not going.
There's coffee.
Yeah, I'm staying for coffee.
Yeah, it's under new business. Tour.
Ready when you are.
Okay.
Make it short.
I will.
Sit up.
But don't stand and stare.
To the bank.
That comes to this meeting to see Joel's combining wheat function.
Yeah, you can spy on them from here.
Yeah.
Can you lay it back?
Yep.
Go ahead, Joe.
I have questions I have for Mike to finish up our audit. So, do you have anything in the shop?
No.
You're not recircing?
No, sir.
You got the gas information from Brett. How many pickers did you have today?
Two.
Random load?
Oh, it was the 27th. Is that right? Gotta make sure it's not Saturday.
That's Monday.
I recall the 27th.
Average tonnage?
1900.
MSW special waste. What else?
That sums it up.
Anything coming up?
No, unfortunately not.
You okay with signing it after the meeting?
Sure.
Well, as we all saw, landfill, the daily cover is good, the intermittent cover is very good. The only spot that there was flagging was a little bit at that corner. Mike even pointed out that it needed more play. The only odors I detected were when we come back down. That's the only odors I've been experiencing. I've not been experiencing gas odors. The odor that you smell getting in and out of the van, and if you're over in the parking lot, is the odor from the tank right over here, where they put the odor back into the gas. Brett says that on a rainy day it spreads around, but I've never smelled it on the highway. No erosion rails. For the most part, everything's been running smoothly.
Brett, why do you have that mercaptan seem to be escaping all over the place?
We just had someone here to look at it, and I mean, it's one drop of that will essentially fill up the whole area.
Mm-hmm.
A lot more potent than what it is here, so. I mean, I think it's just the nature of the machine.
Every gas
without it is.
Into, you can smell.
Yeah, you're always going to have a little bit of odor with it, and the windier the day is, a lot more it carries. Usually, you can maybe smell it if you go within 5 feet of it, but not very bad. But today is a little windy, so it carries a lot further. And we just had someone here to service it for a problem that we were having with it 2 or 3 weeks ago. I don't remember exactly this year. He tidied everything up and, you know, refit everything too. So it should all be, all the fittings should be tight and stuff.
So what you're saying is it's as good as it's going to get?
From my understanding, yes.
Anything else, Joe?
No, I don't think so.
Anybody else have any questions with Joe? Status of projects, clay extraction?
I believe the last amount of clay that we trucked out of here was the beginning of July. That project is now over. That was the MMSD project. So the only clay extraction that's going on would be for daily cover use.
Unless something else should come in.
Right, another project or someone's looking for some clean soil.
Police firing range?
Nothing new to report.
Is there going to be anything further on that?
No, not that, I mean, they took care of, we took care of the berm last year, and that was, I think, an issue that you had. So
right.
Other than that.
And have you had a chance to look at the berm this year to see what condition it's in?
I'm not a personal inspector, but PD seems happy with it.
We go over it during audits. It's in immaculate shape.
It is?
No, it's right there. And that's
right, I know it is.
Yeah, so when the, if either side started to fail, the thing reshapes rather quickly. And I've looked, taken a look once or twice at the other side when the PD aren't there. But it is, it looks very good, it's in better shape. It's not quite as hot.
When they're not firing.
So they're not there, no. That's a good idea. They're not coming in.
I thought this was cool. That's
quite a good idea. We're dry firing.
The fences haven't been restored, but technically the security's out of the street, so I never saw a reason to make a comment about that.
Okay, well, as a status of project, we're done with that, so I just think it can be removed from the agenda. No objection? Dave, you want to remove that? Household hazardous waste?
Is that me?
That's you.
All right. I did send this so that you had it electronically. I only have 10 copies, so maybe if the ABS guys don't need it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
You only sent it to Dave electronically?
Yes.
On first reading, so
yeah. all of that for every group and an operation of the contract into the larger database. But I will still also give you, because I reconcile against their monthly reports that they send us, I reconcile the invoices that they give us versus this, and then to our database. So just so you have all the information on each site, each of the mobiles, and then the county data as well. So I don't have much else to say except I think it's crossed, or hoping and prayer that we stay at that $300,000 marker so we don't have any meetings in 2 months or start making further decisions on sites and closures.
It's good to hear that. It sounds like John has kind of picked up with the program a little bit.
Yes.
Working with you instead of against you.
It is nice. You know, we had one of the Waukesha site is a busy site, so I think that now has become the only site that's become a challenge, because that was such a costly site. When we reduced the hours, we reduced it in half. So we that took a big cut, and so the residents are trying to get used to it, the city staff is trying to get used to it, and the operators trying to get used to it. So he's actually, for a few months, brought more staff there, but I didn't allow a charge for it because I thought that, you know, we just need to get over kind of a hump here with them, with the residents, with the contractor, and then things will smooth out. So him and I have both been watching how many pounds are coming in, how many cars and people are coming in, to see if I can say, okay, well, all right, if you're getting, you know, 20% more pounds than the previous year at the same time, then yes, you should be having extra staff on site. So he's been good at letting me review data, and he's been meeting me in the middle, I guess I could say. So, yes,
good.
It has been nice. I don't think he wants a shutdown anymore.
Any other questions, comments? MSD project, is that basically done now as far as a project?
Yes, as far as we know, it's done.
Okay.
So it was an estimated 90,000 tons of material.
Okay.
90,000 tons of dirt material that came in.
Okay.
We probably exported 60 to 70,000 cubic yards of clay. Went right back to the site for filling.
So would they use the clay to line the basins that they created, or?
They just filled in there, the voids where they took out the material and brought it here.
Oh.
I guess it was next to a river. I never got down there to look at the site. I wanted to a bunch of times, but when they were hauling, it was extremely busy. 50 trucks on some days. So yes, to answer your question, the job is complete.
Okay. And the MSD gas line project is complete also?
Yes.
So now there's just operational issues?
Correct.
Okay. But in terms of the system, it has all been signed off on and agreed to as being complete?
Brett's been at it since the beginning, so maybe he's
the answer. The construction is complete. We still are under negotiation contractually wise with them for various circumstances.
Operational.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, and the impacts of the negotiations, how can that negatively affect things?
I haven't really been privy to the negotiations. I mean, that's been done by our CFO and stuff at this point. I mean, negatively negotiating, we're still negotiating certain pay, you know, what's considered conforming and non-conforming gas on our end. It shouldn't negatively affect delivery. two vessels, that's right, yeah, and we supply both.
Okay, so basically, MMSD project can be removed from the agenda?
Yes.
Just as a FYI, it'll be in, either on the news or you may see it in publications, there's an O&M for the pipeline contract being led right now to maintain it, do the clean out of the drop downs and so on, the blowouts. But that's outside of you guys.
Yeah, I didn't even know they were redoing that out again, because they always had, the original contractor was doing it, I didn't know they put that on the bid.
I think the original contractor's.
Probably.
The only reason I know is there's concern that when they clean out the drop pots, they'll have all this leachate and want to bring it back to landfill, I'm like, no.
They've done it, yeah, they've done it, I mean, they've done it at, every quarter they go and they've gotten a total of 2 gallons of liquid, every time they've done it, there's nothing, yeah, so.
But I do know that that letting is coming up, I'm sure it'll be published when it comes out.
Tell me why there is liquid at all in that line, based on the dryness of the gas that you're giving them. You should be able to take that gas down to 20 degrees and nothing will come out of it.
Well, we're not using the glycol dehydrator for drying our gas anymore, it never worked. So we're using other, our that's part of our negotiating right now is the water content of the gas, it's kind of that way that hang up. We have higher delivery limits at certain parts of the year. But most of the time when they have it in it, they don't believe it's condensate from the gas. They think it's coming from rainwater and the drop pot somewhere or something. So they're not even sure what it is. Because they've tested it once and the condensate. But. I don't have much interaction with them on that.
Okay.
That's all them.
Alternative recycling?
Going well. We call them, they come pick it up, and I don't think the city has any issues.
No, our reports were due last week. I don't have the pounds here, but I think it was in the range of 40,000 pounds or something like this. Picking up the exact stuff for this thing. I don't remember what it is. So.
Yeah, when you say this year, what does that mean?
They go from July 1 to July 1.
Okay, the charges that you're getting from the recycler, are they within the expected range or are they starting to go outside of it or are they what?
A little outside over there, maybe. So we're working.
So the county released a proposal on behalf of 8 communities as a coordinated effort to try to understand what options for electronic recycling are available. And actually, I just got the results today from DOA, so I will be preparing, and I'll make it a priority this week to prepare a summer report about the options available to the communities, whether, and but the county will award each, will make an award recommendation. Non-binding recommendation to each of the 8 which the city participated in, saying who would be the highest ranked vendor. Remember, it's a proposal, not a bid, so it's a little different. It's not necessarily the lowest cost, but the highest ranked vendor for collection events and permanent site events or permanent site collections. And so what we were hoping is that there would be some no-cost options, and what it came down to is that doesn't exist anymore in the electronics recycling world, and that there may be cost options outside of televisions. So if we were able to perhaps separate electronics, which also doesn't seem to be a feasible permanent site operation, that there could be no cost options and perhaps rebates, but because at most permanent sites everything gets mixed together and commingled, there is just a general per pound cost to cover the cost of those televisions that do come in. So we'll be looking at it, but just know that the no-cost options will likely only exist on the taxpayer or the tax roll under the general levy if we do collection events such as Dave is doing with recyclers and have the residents pay for the individual products that are the cost. is willing to host events, we'll be hosting a meeting, so I'll be asking if you have a meeting request as well, so we can to pull all parties together and see what we want to happen.
Yeah, so it was $15 per TV and an event, is what we charged.
How many did you get, do you remember roughly?
200 and some TVs, I would say, that's just.
Nothing.
How long is the winter shop to get up here? About 2 years, a little longer than that, hard to run on this time. It's a while. It's a, we just did a 7 year renewal.
Okay.
So, when you leave, you can try to.
I started with Miriam Johnson.
Yeah, seven, we just resigned for 7 years.
But when you drive out tonight, you can drive right past the E-box, it's mostly CRTs and TV sets.
Yep.
And that's, you know, when was the last CRT or TV set made?
Well, it's because there's no reusable options in the community anymore, so people are desperate.
Now, would that be considered a vector, Mike, that big brown hog outside, or is that?
No, that's pet.
That's pet, okay.
Mascot, man.
Can't put it down on my own, just behind a rat.
I thought that was a security.
Yeah, it's impressive.
Yeah.
Also handling the weed control as well, I noticed he was eating.
And security.
He's eating a turkey lot grass, keeping those weeds down.
There you go.
He doesn't mind the smell.
That's weed control.
Always a gardener.
A mutant.
I know, he's gonna pitch next week.
So all the free disposal options for TVs are gone?
The city's position is that we want to provide the continued rest service.
Oh, yeah.
Most costs, I don't see any reason why we'd ever stop providing service. It's not really crazy expensive. How we do that would change, but we'll see what the meetings come to look like.
But TVs are really the things that are pushing this?
Yes.
And is it just CRTs or is it?
CRTs and LCD monitors.
And LCD? Because you're going to have LCDs for forever. I say that, but it's going to be quite a long time.
I think in general, the CRTs have their own issues.
Yeah, I mean, the understanding is the type of glass used for the CRT. Treatment of the vacuum, the removal of the vacuum, the capacitors, those are all big issues for on the recycling and handling side.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the reuse, the glass itself doesn't have a big reuse market. So the glass is tons of waste. The LCDs, I remember reading, it's the actual crystal removal. So if they're not broken, they have a cash value because you're going to recover the LCD. But more often than not, they're broken. That's the only way they fail, is when the liquid is lost. That's the reading I've done on electronics recycling.
Okay. Any other questions on electronic recycling? Property protection, sociological program?
All good.
All good. How many homes are you up to this year?
Purchase?
Yeah.
Or up for, what did we buy this year? One.
One?
Just buy Skips?
No, we haven't bought Skips yet.
Oh, the sign came down.
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
One so far.
Okay. So, you can do 5 a year for the contract, right?
Right.
Well testing, well water protection area. Running fine?
Yes.
Okay. Land modification issues?
None. None for this, for over the last 2 months anyway.
And none planned?
I never know. We could come up with something tomorrow for a plan mod.
Nothing in the wind?
Correct.
Okay, new business, discussion. discussion update, possible action relative to landfill tour. I do have one thing, that is, after the open forum, when we have a landfill tour, we want to put that as a item before the compliance officer report. So we just say, you know, landfill tour. Nice big letters. Comments, questions on the landfill tour?
Thank you again for the tour.
Yes, thank you, Mike. And
sure. I think it looks pretty good.
Yes.
Looks clean, picked up.
Thank you.
So it's good to see the progress and what the new things are coming up with.
Who comes tomorrow?
Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Yeah. Board of Directors for Advanced Disposal. They're stopping by. Take a look. So
it's like it looks something.
Always looks good.
Have you done any special to accommodate them?
No. Other than knocking down some weeds, things like that, that, you know, we've stepped that up a little bit, you know. I mean, they're always, you've got a good team of people here. So they've all been here a long time, so they understand what needs to be done every day. It's just once in a while you gotta, you know, remind them of things to stay up on, which is no different anywhere else.
Yeah. I think just surrounding roads look nice. You guys do a decent job of picking up on them.
Yeah, they try to stay on it. We don't like getting the phone call and then having to go out. So we like to get out and get it picked before we get the phone call.
Well, I like that you were able to take us on those back roads back there, give us a little better idea of what the neighborhood back there is and the perimeter of the property too. I don't think we've seen that the last couple of years.
I don't think so. I don't think I've ever been back to it before.
We graveled it last year, so you had a. And there is a section still that we got to get gravel on the back side.
Yeah.
But you should have all access all the way around the site.
And once a quarter, I get access. And not every audit, we go all the way around, especially when it's been very rainy.
Mm-hmm.
And before they had the gravel, but at least once a quarter, we've made it all the way around.
Mm-hmm.
And I should point out, I was teasing Mike about who's coming this week, but the drainage blanket covering is something that happened well before.
Special cleanup, but it probably will have an effect on their gas operation and potential work. Really, the question was, do you have anything good, bad, or indifferent about the landfill tour?
No, I think they're doing a great job, really do. The roads are kept up, like you were saying, they have very little odor, cover looks good. I go by here every day.
Yeah.
They're picking up litter every day or whatever, you know. So I think they're doing a good job.
Okay.
They're trying to be good neighbors.
Okay, item number two is I asked to have it on the put on the agenda, and it's supposed to read upkeep and weed mowing of advanced owned properties.
That sounds,
it's funny about that.
And
transplanting
this
weeds.
Huh?
If
yeah.
You're transplanting weeds.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure there's a lot of people. I took a ride down 8 Mile, and what really triggered it was the property that you own, that I believe Wanda used to rent, and that looks, it looks abandoned. And that's just an open invitation for kids to go after that property and take it from whatever condition it's in now to totally destroy it and do it very quickly and or set it on fire in the middle of the night.
Mm-hmm. Our plan is to demo the home.
Okay.
So I have to get permits from Norway, City Hall.
Okay, so a town of Norway is the hang up?
I'm the hang up. I can't blame the town, because I haven't been there yet.
Oh.
So I gotta get the permits going. And then we gotta abandon the well. And we gotta get the power shut off. And it's just got LP service out there, so I'll just come pick up the tank. And then I gotta line up a contractor to tear it all down and then get it all inspected by the town of Norway. So you're probably looking at 2 months.
But they did mow.
Before it comes down.
But you did mow. I saw it was mowed down. They did mow those weeds down.
Oh, it is mowed?
Yes.
Okay, because that had to be quick, because I think the last time I was down there was Friday.
We did it yesterday.
Very good.
Could've been.
Somebody saw you drive by, Mark.
Sorry, why I drove in.
Oh, okay.
There was another property down here, I think, across from your place, Artie?
And it's mowed also.
That's all mowed?
Well.
We do gotta get over there and take care of the weeds. And that'll happen this week.
Okay.
In the down tree.
In the tree.
Really? I'll take care of the weeds.
The big issue is thistle.
Just don't drag it across the street.
The big issue is thistle.
Right.
Do you have any ordinance down Norway on thistle?
Not just weeds.
Yeah.
We'll come and mow them, we'll bill you.
Yeah.
Do it all the time. Call them up, they'll come out. Put it on your tax bill.
Probably more cost effective for you to do.
Yeah, we'll cut them down.
That house was in that bad a shape that...
Yes.
Was that one that they just let go before they sold it, or what?
Pretty much.
The individuals that were renting it, that are no longer renting it, didn't keep it. They had some issues.
Okay.
Less than stellar tenants, right?
Yeah.
Previously, when it was owned, when you bought it, was it?
Brett could
it was not in the best of shape. We put a little bit of money into it ourselves before we rented it out to try and bring it up. We did, but it wasn't what you would call the best. I mean, you know, it wasn't a stellar house to live in.
Okay.
Is this the property that backs up to the compost lot?
No, okay. It's on the other side of the mile. Yeah, down quite a ways too.
The other large house is on 8 Mile. Right across from Joe Holderman.
Mm-hmm. Big fancy one.
That's being rented out.
It is.
We didn't want that to happen to that house.
Yeah, well,
I can't
think
imagine.
So. Yeah. A few nickels in that one.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, isn't your plan to eventually sell all the residential properties, or are you going to be in the rental business too?
No, the company's plan, corporation, is to sell the property. And hopefully get out of the rental business. Because we're not very good renter people.
That's your forte.
No.
Being a landlord is not it.
No.
So in 2 months?
Or so.
Nothing happens that fast with this landfill.
Okay, tell me what is the tolerance on your OSO?
I would think, I should have it all demoed but in 3 months. Where does that put us? September, October, November?
November 15th.
Yeah.
November 15th should be gone.
Okay.
Is that right?
Sure. Yeah, I know a guy that worked or associated with the town.
other questions, comments concerning advanced owned properties, upkeep? Okay. Review payments made from committee funds, Dave?
I have all the, I believe you combined the funds that was discussed previously.
Okay. Questions, comments? Confirm next meeting date? Should be October. Okay, everybody's okay with that? The reason for having this on the agenda is in case something comes up during the year that we can obviously make adjustments.
What's the time going to be on that? 4:30 or 4?
5. 4.
5?
5.
Mm-hmm. The hours were 5, right?
You wanted 5? No, we were at 4:30. We went to 5.
So we need it at 5 or 4:30?
Well, it doesn't make any difference. 4:30, 5 o'clock.
Well, which is it?
I'd go for 5.
5, fine.
Say 5.
5 is acceptable?
Yes.
Okay. Any other communications? Business is authorized by law?
Move to adjourn.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? We are adjourned at 5:41 p.m.